knowledge is imported from three sources: China, Arab, and Greece. It is saying that this knowledge has been, see, how we can understand the origin of a particular transaction. There is a logical question. If somebody is having more and if somebody is receiving something, there will be a possibly logistic way of understanding their possessions and evaluating who will be the receiver and who will be the bestower. Likewise, at that time, we have been having innumerable shastras like Rasavada, Kautukvada, Bipilavada, Agneya Vidya, Varuna Vidya, Chaudhamini Kala, Mantra Shastra, Jyotish Shastra, Vaidya Shastra, Vijnana Shastra, Tantrika Vijnana, Arthaveda, Dhanurveda, Ayurveda, Gandharva Veda, innumerable things that have been existing. So a complete structure is seen in our land, and only traces of our wisdom is there imported through migration, colonization by means of messengers visit, and total at that time they were having intellectual tourism. Often they used to send messengers. So invasion, colonization, migration, trade and messengership, that has created some transaction of our knowledge to three routes. One is Indo-China route, and second is Indo-Greek route, and third is Indo-Arab route, which has resulted in the formation of sciences like mathematics, astronomy, astrology, metallurgy, meteorology, textile technology, and various other institutions. We did not deny the development of the West. We are telling everything because if a nomadic civilization and a new civilization could prosper more, what were the reasons that so advanced people could not prosper competitively? Why we are in a degraded position? Not to create some sort of past boasting, or not to create some sort of self-flattery of our own culture and civilization. It is for understanding the failure investigation of our development, which was stagnate for a long period by means of colonization, invasion, Muslim invasion, various other things, and dilution of our own standards. That's what I told you in one seminar. It is a very wonderful statement that I quoted. I quoted the same thing. Those people who are empowered by yoga and Vedanta, those people entered into mere shastras, quarreling with each other with logics. So that type of spiritual power making or empowerment with spiritual exercises have been reduced to mere quarrelsome or debating sciences. Those debating sciences are also, that intellectual, dry intellectual quest are also mitigated and transformed or reformed into the process of fine arts. They have been showing more interest in art, architecture, music, painting and dancing and other various exercises. When these people have been very much slowed down, when they have been totally disorganized and dismantled from spiritual empowerment, this invasion, colonization, everything occurred at the time of which they have lost their constitutional immunity of the land and spiritual immunity of their practices and determination. That is a major reason. It is for the failure investigation of these things. Likewise, in China also, we have the Xing dynasty and Shang dynasty. Even we start from the Paleolithic as well as the Neolithic ages until the Wing dynasty and Qing dynasty of the 190 AD, starting from 2700 AD, still each and everybody, they have some history. There are three types of nations. One nation, that which has no historical record and civilization record, that which land is occupied by just tribes, where penal colonies or uninhabited colonies are tribally or native occupied colonies which have been invaded or just migrated and occupied by people. That is the first level of nations. The mediocre level of nations, those who have civilization, some civilization in the riverbank, wherein by they know how to clothe, how to make the shelter, how to make everything. These are all the marks of initial civilization, not inner civilization, initial civilization. That is the second thing. Those who are having the perennial fragrance of the eternally unfadable greenness of civilization with the truth and utmost completion and consummation, that people, they are said to be the superior in nature. What is civilization? We described in the lecture. The ability of a person to understand and react three things: that which is around him, that which is behind him, that which is beyond him, that is known as civilization. That which is around a person is known as environment and society, human beings. That which is behind everything is known as science. That which is beyond everything is spiritualism. Spiritualism, science and society, this triple S, if it is understood, organized and executed, that is the mark of civilization. I know how to clothe and I know how to inside a cave, I know how to cook in fire. These things are just instinctive derivations or drivings of civilization. Now we are having all the people, those who are now terrorists, they are very decent, educated, they know how, they are computer literate, they are Anglo literate, they are well civilized, but the inner civilization is not there with them. That is the problem. So, whenever we are taking the history, first duty of Vishwadhyayana Kendra, Vishwadhyayana means anybody interested in understanding the universal outframe of Hinduism or our Dharma is known as Vishwadhyayana. The first meaning I have already told. Like that, they have to understand the history. They have to understand not the inscriptive history, but a para-historical record or an auto-historical record, which is based on belief, which is not superstitious, but super-institutional by means of understanding somebody is great, unintelligible, or far beyond the records of historical pronouncement. So this is the greatness of historical understanding, where we have to outrule so many things like Aryan invasion theory. Recently, they have outruled Aryan invasion theory by saying that there are a lot of tests, physical anthropology. Those who are dark skin and bright skinned, even the same traditions of the native people who are existing here called to be Dravidians, they have invented a lot of people who are having the physical, anthropological, chromatic or complexion status of having a bright skin like Aryans. And second, the materials archaeology, whatever they got from Indus Valley, they are very much compatible to that of the Vedic religion. And third thing is archaeogenetics, linguistics, historical references in the Vedas. They understood that there was a Saraswati river civilization, the places mentioned by the Aryans, that absolutely the places that have been mentioned here, and they are very much native of our people. Like that, we have to have some sort of rectification of our own land, that number one, we are senior most people in civilization, we have a broader civilization, we have a complete civilization, not only instrumental civilization, but also inner civilization. Number fourth thing, and we are inhabitants, and this knowledge is our own native knowledge, and it is also for universal bestowal. You have to understand two things. We should not think that it has come from somewhere else. It has come for us, from us, and it is not over exclusively for our development. It is to be distributed whenever the world has some sort of readiness or preparedness to open 2 years. If it is before 200 or 300 years, nobody in the West was prepared to hear about yoga, about Ayurveda. Whenever all the doors are closed for their solace, for their comfort, for domestic harmony, for physical health, whenever science and technology has become additional disasters along with the national disasters and natural disasters, then the people, they survived only in the hope of getting hopeful drive or a ladder uplift from our own nation. So now the society in a position to understand the greatness of Vedas, which they would not have understood before 2 or 3 centuries. So this is, we should understand the history, rewrite the history, establish the history, and that's what I told in a seminar, what do you think about your culture? Then I told that whenever I think of my culture, I am proud. Whenever I see my culture in the present stage, I feel painful. I feel grateful if I think about my culture, but if I see my culture, I feel painful. If I feel that I have not contributed much or sufficient, I feel shameful. That's what I told. That should be the spirit of each and every fool, every person, those who are existing in the same community. They should feel grateful for the past and painful for the present and shameful for their non-participation or inadequate participation. And they should design themselves that they are proper tools for that thing. And apart from that, linguistic, you should do surveys on some research orientation, especially on linguistics and literature of our land and how it is very much applicable to modern problems, emerging predicaments and their solutions. That is known as linguistic survey. It is very much essential. Third thing is arts and sciences. Now recently they have made NBIC convergence, nanotechnology, biotechnology, infotechnology, cognotechnology convergence. In the cognotechnology, what the scientists know is, if you can't remember things, you create a chip. Either by a neuroprosthetic or a software chip, you have to replace your ability. Not creation of inner ability is the destination or determination of modern science. To replace everything by a scientific or technical matter and to keep you perennially incapable or handicapped or techno-dependent is the present status of technology. I delivered 2 lectures about NBIC convergence, and I am guiding a lot of people in developing inner cognitive ability skill by which we can invent more things and create more fusions and utility designs in nanotechnology, biotechnology and infotechnology. We are designing that. Like that, what is the modern status in physical, intellectual and mind making, emotional balancing, talent boosting, talent identification, multi-versatility, extra power memory, multilinguistic skills, whatever that is applicable, whatever that is traceable for a modern need, we have to develop some sort of adhyana. That is Vishwadhyana. Vishwadhyana is making a curriculum or a system of knowledge by which our traditional knowledge can suit any time, any demand for any person, for any benefit. So it is known as Vishwadhyana. So it is attunement of our own knowledge, which should be redesigned, or it should be very much assembled in such a design so that it can accommodate any system, any demand to any gravity of any person in any corner of the world. That is Vishwadhyana. And one more thing I want to say about the greatness of our land, very simple thing.